passing in each of his last two games, three of them overall this season. That's the most by any FBS player. He starts from the gun, and he throws it to the outside. That's complete to Quentin Lane. And with Jack State, they're going to go all tempo. By the way, there was a late hit out of bounds on that opening kickoff. The read option off the left side is Wiggins. Ron Wiggins, he's the fastest of the running backs for the Gamecocks. Returned from a five-game absence just last week. It's a first down, and that's what Jack State wants. They want a series of first downs and run this defense ragged. Webb's going to keep it, and he's brought down at the line of scrimmage.
Now, Webb is a true dual-threat guy. He's an excellent runner, much like a running back, solid passer.
Here's Webb. That one's batted. Alex Huntley, this guy got his hand up, got that big paw up.
Can't go fast if you can't get first downs, right?
Third and nine for Jacksonville State. Webb. The Quentin Lane, he's about a yard or two shy of a first down.
Tremendous tackle by Fortune, number three, chasing that crossing route. That is, you can't play that any better than that. And if you want to handle a team that goes fast, handle that tempo, don't let them get a first down.
Jack Dawson has come to punt things away. He's the transfer out of Troy. Averages about 41 yards a kick. Jalen Kilgore back deep for South Carolina. Standing at his own 28. Makes a man miss and is across the 35. Well, let's get a look at Spencer Rattler. Let's get to know him. Mario Anderson, Juju McDowell, two backs. Rattler keeps it. He's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Larry Worth makes the tackle. That's a loss of one.
Yeah, Rattler has seen it all in his career, going from Heisman front runner a few years ago to a guy who was benched in place of Caleb Williams and transferring.
Rattler under pressure, scrambling, throwing on the run, complete. It's Xavier Leggett. That's across midfield. Is in Gamecocks territory. It's a pickup of 17. Rattler needs just 262 passing yards. Become the 14th active player with 10,000 career passing yards at the FBS level. That's a give to Anderson. Anderson bounces it outside. Anderson gets to the edge, down the sideline, and forced out of bounds at the 7-yard line. Derek Carter make the stop and save the touchdown. 40-yard pickup for South Carolina.
Tremendous job by Anderson. The edge, the good blocking on the edge, and a bad pursuit angle inside. Anderson takes advantage of it and gets to the outside. And man, when you lose the edge, Anderson makes you pay for it.
Something, considering this is a kid, Anderson, a transfer from Division II, and has come and become their main running back. From the pistol, it's Anderson again. Puts his head down and brought down at the 2. 3-yard pickup. Fred Perry with the stop for Jacksonville State.
This is where South Carolina says, so you want to play an SEC team, right? Well, we got big boys up front. We're inside the 5. We're not going to get fancy here. We're just going to show you that we're a little bigger and stronger and run it right at you.
South Carolina has scored a first quarter touchdown in 7 of their 8 games this season. They go heavy. And dives in. Touchdown, South Carolina. Tonka Hemingway gets in, big boy, from 2 yards out.
Dare I say it? A movable feast. If you're a Hemingway fan. Give it to the big guy. He says, I'm not following my guy. I can slip onto the outside and make it happen. What a tremendous, tremendous move by the big fella.
Here's another look. Let's see that knee. They may want to take another look here at that knee, because that knee looked like might have come down.
Can't take a touchdown away from a big guy. How many chances will he get? Ball across the lane, across the line. For whom the bell tolls, the sun also rises.
Yeah.
That Hemingway name, right?
Here's Mitch Jeter for the extra point. And it's South Carolina who strikes first. 7-0, our score. 5 plays, 62 yards. They do it in 2 minutes. And Coach Shane Beamer, he said they remember in November. And he believes that they have played their best football under his tenure, his third year now here in Columbia in November. They've knocked off Tennessee, Clemson, Florida, Auburn, just to name a few squads that they have taken out in the month of November.
Well, they got to get their confidence back. Losing 4 in a row will zap your confidence. That's why today's game is so big for them to get going in the right direction. If they're going to have a shot at getting to a bowl game, they need to play well today.
Defense had a good start. Here's Webb, little jet sweep. Wiggins spinning and a pickup of 7.
That is a big first down play for Jack State. The quarterback run game, how will South Carolina play it? How will they attack the quarterback?
The give is to Wiggins, and he gets upended. What a play by Jordan Strong, the transfer out of Georgia State.
Well, you said it, partner. I mean, he just really cut through there in a hurry. Nice play, knifing through, quickness, unblocked.
That's a loss of 3. Third down now, and 6. Webb rolling, under pressure, throwing too high. How about the defense under defense coordinator Clayton White in the start?
Yeah, you know, if you're worried about tempo, I mean, 3 and out eliminates that issue. And when you force Webb to be a thrower on the move, that's not his ideal positioning for throwing the football. So great start for the South Carolina defense.
And keep in mind, under Rich Rodriguez, listen, he will flip quarterbacks depending on how they're doing. High snap, the punt gets off, takes a roll. And it is down at the 24-yard line. That's a 48-yard punt. You can see Jacksonville State was asking if it hit a South Carolina player. Whoa, that's close. That's close. First and 10 for South Carolina. Rattler throwing. He's got a man. That's complete. Amarion Brown.
How about that elite arm talent? I mean, when you protect him, he shows you why he's an NFL prospect. I mean, little move, and watch this. Just a beautiful throw.
Quick release, 19-yard pickup there. Keep it on the ground to Anderson.
The best way to help out Spencer Rattler is to run the football. His offensive line has been beat up, injured, 9 different combinations this season.
Yeah, they've used a different starting 5 along that offensive line every game this season. Rattler, plenty of time though. Swings it out to Juju McDowell. And Juju is close to midfield.
You know, talking to Spencer Rattler about this season, you know, he told us, you know, he's trying to be a good teammate and a good leader, embracing the adversity and overcoming these things and fighting with his guys. And this is something he didn't expect to have to deal with his senior year. They expected to be a winning team.
Rattler over the middle, knocked away. He was looking at Xavier Leggett. Fred Perry.
Watch the play by Harris here. Times it perfectly. Left hand on the backside of the receiver. Reach around. Perfectly done.
Leggett's been dealing with some injuries. Upper body injury. He's had.
He's not right. He's not right.
He didn't look right in pregame.
No, he's not right.
Jamari Joyner is back deep for Jacksonville State. Ty Kroger will putt things away. Fair catch at the 15. 8:38 here in the first quarter. 7-0 our score here in Columbia.
Hey, coach, don't do that. Last time I was a captain, didn't go so well. So, no, I can't be captain.
He's superstitious as well.
Yeah.
Jacksonville State, first two series, total of just 16 yards. Malik Jackson in the backfield. They pitch it to him. Jackson. Pickup of two. Debo Williams makes the stop for South Carolina.
They have stymied this rushing attack so far.
One of the best in the country. Quickly to the outside. Winton Lane with the catch. And again, here comes the tempo of Jacksonville State. They'll go five wide here. Webb steps up, tipped, and incomplete. Stone Blanton was the one who got that big paw on it.
And if Blanton doesn't get his hand up, that's a first down. And Blanton, 52, drops into this window. Well, look at this. And gets his hand up. That's going to be a first down if he doesn't make that play. Tremendous play.
One of the team captains, as you see, Rich Rod sitting there talking to Zion Webb. So they've had three offensive series, and they've punted it away all three times. Jack Dawson will do the punting. Jalen Kilgore. Oh, they almost got it. And Dawson is down at the 10. The punter.
No flag.
Let's see if someone got even a hand on that one. Yards is what the punt went.
Yeah,
nothing was, much there.
Yeah, and he didn't get hit by the guy who went by him. Nice acting job.
Very.
But the officials were right there and didn't buy it.
First and 10 for the Gamecocks. We'll be saying that a lot today. Here's Mario. Super Mario. Picks up one.
Well, I'm curious to see the matchup with Leggett on the outside. We know that he hasn't been moving great, number 17. But he is a legitimate potential first-round pick in the NFL draft. That guy, Mel Kiper Jr., really likes him.
We got another offensive lineman coming off the field. Ja'Kai Moore down to the field, and Lauren.
You guys talk about the talent of Leggett, and Coach Loggins said that when he first arrived, Xavier really caught his attention. There was some doubt, especially from some of the scouts and coaches, not quite sure what he was all about, but he's been a big-time playmaker for them, a special talent. But because you're right, earlier in the game and during warm-ups, he didn't quite look himself.
Dowell Loggins, offensive coordinator for South Carolina. That was Anderson, forced out of bounds after an 8-yard pickup.
Leggett is a big receiver, 6'3", 227, has been clocked at about 22 miles per hour. That's up there with the elite speedsters in college football.
Anderson and McDowell in the backfield. This is McDowell.
Wow. Wow.
How about that play?
Wow.
Devin Baldwin,
yeah,
makes the stop. And listen, for Jacksonville State, they've got 66 tackles for loss.
Yeah,
that's the sixth most in the country.
It's a very aggressive defense. They believe in stunting and blitzing. And you saw the quickness and the move by Baldwin to get into the backfield. And at 270 pounds, chase down that running back.
Zach Alley, defensive coordinator for Jacksonville State. Of course, he came over University of Louisiana Monroe.
Not a lot of rhythm or flow to this game yet. A lot of three and outs.
South Carolina is going to call a timeout.
South Carolina has called their first charge timeout of the half. It's 30 seconds in length.
Well, today on ABC, number 9, Oklahoma takes on 22nd ranked Oklahoma State in Stillwater, 3:30 Eastern. And then you got 5th ranked Washington. They're going to be at the Coliseum taking on 20th ranked USC. Coverage begins 7:30 Eastern. Kai Kroger back to punt things away, standing at his own 20. Jacksonville State showing like they're coming after it. Jamari Joyner calling for a fair catch. Oh, and he got ran into. There's the flag.
Kick catch interference, kicking team number 17. The penalty is 15 yards from the spot of the foul. First down, Jacksonville State. Timeout.
Jason Audrey, a referee, 54-yard punt, and it's going to cost him some yardage as well, as Coach Beamer, who loves special teams, does not like this at all. 7-0 our score. Battle of the Gamecocks, 7-0 our score. Zion Webb fakes the pitch, looking, throwing, and in and out of the hands.
Oh, they got to have that one.
Michael Petway.
Gotta have that one. This was a well-designed play off of the man under coverage, gets free. Wow, perfectly thrown ball by Zion Webb.
Here's Wiggins spinning, getting back to the line of scrimmage, and that was it. And Martin Scott.
South Carolina defense, very aggressive, attacking, moving their front, not sitting still. Trying to make sure they take away the inside run. The quarterback option game, that is the issue. What's going to happen with that?
Webb swinging it out to Ron Wiggins. Wiggins reversing field. Wiggins has got a first down. Spins off another man. Cross midfield. And finally forced out of bounds. What a run by Ron Wiggins. 16 yards the hard way.
It is rare to say a guy did it by himself. Well, Wiggins just did that by himself. Reversed his field, ran through a couple tackles. Biggest play for Jack State so far.
Malik Jackson is checked into the backfield now. And it's Jackson who gets the carry over that left side. Best field position of the day so far for Jacksonville State.
I expect that we will see some counter, some misdirection by Jack State, because South Carolina is being really aggressive and overplaying that first move.
Webb, design quarterback run. At the 41.
Yeah, that was the first counter. That was pulling the guard and the tight end from the backside. Let's see if they go with more misdirection.
Third and 4. Webb looking down the middle. He's got a man down the seam. It's Perry Carter. He is the big play guy for the Gamecocks.
He got behind Kilgore, the nickelback, on that side. And the safety was too late coming over.
Pickup of 31. Flags come flying in.
Ball start, offense. Never got set prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
What a well-thrown ball. Get it away from the free safety and get it over the head of the nickelback, Kilgore.
Now that they're in the red zone for Jacksonville State, Carter, who made that catch, 14. Usually their tight end, Sean Brown, number 17. The guys they look for. Webb looking, throwing to the end zone, had a man, incomplete. He was looking at Carter.
Pretty good coverage. Really would have had to thread that needle. He sensed a little nervousness here in the stadium. Got a little quiet.
He did get a little quiet. Brown at the bottom of your screen, the tight end. Webb throwing to Brown. Breaks the tackle. To the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville State.
That was grown man football.
Leads the team in touchdown receptions. He's now got four on the season. That's from 15 yards out. And we've got an injured Gamecock in the end zone.
Grown man football there. Brown, 6'5", 250, took that ball away from the defense. Not a whole lot of room. Look at this. And he just spins off of two tackles and runs through two more. That's four missed tackles.
And that's Stone Blanton, who tried to deliver that final hit, who's still down for South Carolina.
Now, remember, these players we talked to this week for Jack State told us that they were looking forward to playing an SEC team in this environment. You think that wasn't a real big moment for Sean Brown? Running through four would-be tacklers.
Alan Karajic will come in for the extra point for Jack State. Flags again. And it's going to be on Jacksonville State.
Number 45, 10-yard penalty, repeat the try.
So we'll have to kick it in now. If that's a 10-yard penalty, does that change your mind about the extra point? Do you try to go for two, or do you just say, okay, let's try to kick it again?
I think you kick it.
All right.
You got a little momentum going.
Okay.
Keep that momentum.
Still good as well. So Karajic knocks it through. And we remain tied at seven. And for Sean Brown, fourth of the season, seventh of his career.
He is a big time tight end. He is an excellent blocker, really good hands. And as you saw there, he can run through tackles. Little action after the catch. The coaches have described him as the glue to their offense. He's the guy that can make plays down the field, but also is really important in the rushing attack because he's such a good blocker on the perimeter.
In fact, the offensive coordinator Rod Smith said, I find him sneaky good and the glue to their entire offense, he said, because he does everything.
Yeah.
Eight plays, 62 yards. And the Gamecocks do it in 2 minutes and 26 seconds to tie this game up. Back deep is Leggett to Kerryon Joyner for South Carolina. Hey, this season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the university's General Scholarship Fund.
Offside, kicking team.
And we say thank you, Allstate. One of the Jacksonville State guys were offside. So they'll add 5 yards. This is already the eighth possession of this quarter.
But it feels like South Carolina hasn't found a rhythm or flow offensively. Had the one big run by Anderson.
Here's Anderson now to the outside. Check that. That's DJ Braswell. Gets the carry.
This defense, a little bit unorthodox, very chaotic. They tend to move their front a lot. They blitz a lot, particularly on first down.
Rattler through the air. Plenty of time. He's got a man. It's Leggett. He got tripped up by the turf monster. Otherwise, it could have been six. But you can see he is not 100% healthy.
Yeah. How about the protection? This is a long, slow, developing route, cross-country route. And Rattler got plenty of time. He wanted Leggett the entire way. Followed him and delivered the ball in time. Great protection.
52 yards. They're in business inside the red zone. Rattler again throwing over the middle. That's complete to Juju. He's brought down at the 7.
How about the protection Rattler is getting? I mean, this guy has not been this well protected all season. I mean, he was sacked, what, seven times last week? Only two quarterbacks have been hit more often this season than he has, but he's being protected today.
They'll go with two tight ends. To the end zone, Joshua Simon. The Gamecocks respond with another touchdown from 8 yards out.
And the hero shot, obviously here, the touchdown throw. But I got to tell you, Simon, shake the hand of all the offensive linemen, because this group has done a tremendous job this last series. I mean, the amount of protection Rattler had was unbelievable.
20th career touchdown catch for Simon. As they take another look at it just to make sure. Let's see. Hand. And that hand touch. Whoa. Man, that's close.
Wow.
It's close.
I'm still blown away by how well this offensive line is playing. Does the ball get in? You know, you see that arm is down. Hard to tell from that angle, but he might be short from that angle. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that arm is down.
Touchdown, the previous play is under video review. Timeout.
They're going to take a longer look.
Yeah, remember, you need video evidence, you clear video evidence to overturn the call on the field. Call on the field is a touchdown. But from that angle, partner, it looked like that arm and elbow was down before the ball broke the plane. To me, that looks like it's pretty clear. That angle would not be sufficient to overturn the call.
Yeah, you would definitely want the pylon cam.
Yeah. This is the one.
There's the
elbow down.
And where's
the ball?
Yeah, ball looks like it's right there at the goal line.
Yeah, maybe a foot or two short.
Mm-hmm. So they're looking at now where that elbow touched and where the ball is.
Isn't pylon cam cool? It's
one of the best things.
Yeah? Can't get that look any other way.
Yeah. Rich Rodriguez.
After video review, the runner was down prior to the ball breaking the goal line. Short, so they'll be short of the goal line. Second down.
So it will be second and goal here with 2 minutes left in this quarter. So no touchdown for Simon.
Yeah, if I were Simon, I'd plead my case. Let me run it. Put me in the backfield. Give me another shot at it. Or do they bring in the big fella? Where's Mr. Hemingway?
Right.
He's already got one touchdown.
Give it to that Tonka truck. Here's Anderson. And Rattler is going to keep it. And score. Fifteenth career rushing TD for Spencer Rattler.
And Spencer Rattler is having a pretty good day. You know, all that we've seen on tape the last few weeks, him being harassed, not able to show his skill set, he's showing it out today.
Extra points good by Mitch Jeter. Rattler is 7 of 8 for 118 yards through the air. And now he can add a rushing touchdown as well.
You see what happens when you give a talented quarterback a little bit of time? He can show you his skill set. We talk about a guy who is going to be an NFL quarterback. He will be drafted. Maybe not the number one guy as he was considered 5 years ago, five-star quarterback coming out of high school. At one point was a leading Heisman Trophy candidate back in 2021. Yeah.
Fourteen to seven, our score, 2 minutes left. Petway and Joyner. Back deep for Jack State. Mitch Jeter will kick things away. Another jet sweep, but he keeps it. Fakes the handoff. Debo Williams makes the stop.
So you're saying it's in Jack State's interest for South Carolina not to make it to a bowl, not to be bowl eligible.
Oh, absolutely. This time, the handoff to Wiggins. He gets upended, but he's a yard shy of the first down.
You know, you were talking about the history of Jack State. I was also surprised to find out they chose...
Wiggins breaks through.
Oh, wow.
Wiggins. Nick Amanwori is the man who ran him down and saved the touchdown.
The right tackle, Xavier Bosley, got a tremendous block to open up a huge hole on the right side.
37-yard pickup for Jack State. Webb slings it to the outside.
Little triple option.
Jason Jones.
Let's go back to that last run. Watch the great blocking on this right side. There you see Bosley, 67, just smother his guy and create a huge hole for Wiggins.
Jacksonville State comes in second in Conference USA, eighth in the nation in rushing. Here's Lewis. Lewis cuts it back. Brought down at the 16. Amanwori makes the stop again. 9-yard pickup.
No intimidation by Jack State. They've come right back, going right at South Carolina. Perimeter rushing attack. quarterback game.
Two tight ends. Last play of the quarter. Lewis. It's a battle of the Gamecocks here in Columbia. Second and seven. Here's the pitch. Perry Carter tried to get over that right edge. About a yard shy of the first down. Third down.
If I'm South Carolina, I got my eyes on 17, tight end Brown. He seems to be in the middle of everything down here.
Webb hands it off to Lewis. That's a first down. So first and goal.
They ran it right at him. That's surprising.
Webb gets to Lewis. And they say it's a score.
Wow.
I thought they stopped him short, but no. And Anwar Lewis gets in, the redshirt junior out of Florida.
This is shocking. This is not an offensive line or front that should be pushing around the South Carolina front seven. And down here in the red zone, watch him just go right out. They just push him right out of the way. Drive, 3-4 yards off the line of scrimmage. I am stunned, partner, at that kind of a push.
Extra point is good. And we are all tied up at 14. Jack State goes 9 plays, 75 yards in 2 minutes and 47 seconds to tie this game up.
Well, and again, the big thing about that drive was the way Jack State finished it. Physically pushing South Carolina out of the way in the red zone, inside the 5. This was not, we're going to trick you, we're going to run option. This was, our line is going to push your guys out of the way.
And how about Rich Rod talking to his offense, offensive line firing them up, saying, look, let's go. Let's keep up with that tempo. So far, Jacksonville State, 83 yards rushing, 81 yards through the air.
Pretty balanced. And they told us balance to them is not the number of plays being equal. It is feeling that you can run when you want and you can pass when you want. Not based on the number of attempts.
Leggett and Joyner back deep for South Carolina. This is Leggett across the 20. All right, let's take a look around the CFP. Rattler, play fake to Simon. He got dropped at the line of scrimmage.
And what a tremendous job over there by Derek Carter, the right corner. He was rolled up as a short corner playing the short area. Beat up the receiver, got him out of the way, and then came and made the tackle. That is tremendous. Jack State will play coverage here, not bringing pressure.
Second and 10 to the outside to Juju McDowell. McDowell makes another man miss. McDowell's loose. Tackle him at the 38. 27-yard pickup.
Jacksonville State tried to disguise their blitz, so they got there late. So the pressure comes late, and Spencer Rattler does a great job of getting the ball out. So mistimed blitz by Jack State.
Anderson in the backfield. He gets the carry. Jalen J-Rock Swain makes the stop for Jack State.
This is not a big defensive front for Jack State. That's why they try to use numbers and movement and pressure to stop the rushing attack.
Mason. Anderson again. Comes flying in the gap. Making that stop is Quay Drake.
That's exactly what we're talking about. Using extra guys to attack the line of scrimmage to stop the rushing attack because they aren't big enough inside. Watch number 10. There he comes. Comes full speed in. Nobody sees him. Easy tackle.
He's the team leader in tackles. He's also the captain of that defense. Meanwhile, South Carolina 0 of 2 here on third down. Looking at third and 8. Leggett at the bottom of your screen. Rattler throwing across the middle, and it's batted down. J-Rock. Boy, he had the game of his life, especially the past couple of weeks. But last week, 6 tackles, 3 of those solo, 3 tackles for loss, 2 sacks, fumble recovery.
And when you play like that, you can tell people, my nickname is J-Rock. Call me J-Rock. You can name yourself. And nobody can say anything about it.
He was the Conference USA Defensive Player of the Week.
He is 5'10", 255 pounds. Plays with great leverage.
How about the fake? And knocked down. And Coach Beamer told us he was going to have something up his sleeve on special teams as they were looking to Leggett. And it was Kai Kroger, the punter, who was throwing it to him.
Well, the problem with that is that it's an incomplete pass. Comes back to about midfield, good field position for Jack State.
Pass incomplete, so good field position here for Jacksonville State. Anwar Lewis hits the carry, who just scored on their last offensive possession.
So riddle me this on this whole mascot thing. So both are Gamecocks.
Right.
Both name their mascots Cocky.
Yep.
Huh.
Yep. Webb keeps it. Debo makes the stop.
Now, South Carolina adopted the mascot first back in 1902.
Okay.
So Jack State just copied them 40 years later?
I got jokes, man. I'm just trying to keep it to myself. Keep this job.
I just find it wild.
You over there getting cocky. Third and 4. Webb looking. Steps up. Throws. Incomplete. It was tipped. He was trying to get it out to Quentin Lane.
Yeah, I think the ball was kind of knocked out of his hand as he was trying to throw it while he was in the pocket.
It just got knocked out.
Yeah. Was that Sanders? I think that was TJ Sanders who knocked it down.
Jack Dawson in to punt things away. Kilgore standing at his own 10. Fair catch at the 14. Tie score here in Columbia. There's Cocky. 10:43 till the half.
They need him back in that lineup.
How about that chain he had as well? Rattler. That's the Simon. He's brought down at the 19. 6 offensive possessions in this game for South Carolina. It's the worst start that they've had in this game inside their own 20.
Were you more impressed with Debo's chain or the feathers on his pants?
Probably that chain. He needs security for that chain. 2nd and 4. To the outside, Marion Brown. That should be enough for a first.
Spencer Rattler has not been knocked down today at all. Been hurried a couple of times, but he has been well protected. That really has been the story of this offense, this ballgame.
He'll hand this one off. Anderson. Give him 3.
I do expect that on one of these first down plays, South Carolina's going to take a shot down the field because Jack State is rolling the dice on first down, bringing blitzes, leaving single coverage on the back end.
See if they target Nick Harbor. He'll sling it out, though, to Anderson, the check down. He's brought down at the 33-yard line.
You mentioned Nick Harbor, their outstanding freshman receiver. He has not been targeted yet today. 6'5", 240 pounds.
He's at the bottom of your screen. Rattler keeping it. And he is just gobbled up. Colby Fuqua.
Yep.
Captain. Best player on that defense. Man who made the play.
Just look at the linebackers attack the line of scrimmage here. I mean, Drake is in there as well. Hell, I mean, they just brought everybody. Nice job on that third and short.
And the Gamecocks of South Carolina have yet to convert on third down. 0-4 now.
Crowd getting a little restless.
They'll punt things away. Jamari Joyner standing at his own 25. Flag.
Delay game. Kicking team. 5-yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
Gotta back them up.
It's fair to say that most fans expected this game to be well in hand by now. You know, they figured Jack State coming over first year, you know, at the top
FBS.
Division
yep.
FBS.
Mm-hmm.
Desperately needing a win for their hometown team, their Gamecocks, figured that they would control this. Not so much.
American here, Columbia. Here's Lewis. Lewis up the middle. Breaks another tackle. And he's close to a first down.
Tremendous double team by the left guard Clay Webb, the center Traylon Brown. Again, the ability to run inside is surprising.
Lewis again bouncing it to the outside, flags everywhere. Stone Blanton tripped him up.
And partner, you know.
Holding, offense, number 69, 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
With each passing minute, Jack State grows more and more confident. Physically, they have to believe now they can hold up. They can run the ball against them, and they can make plays.
There's a hold there on Traylon Brown.
Yep.
So, call it second and 10. Looking at the tight end, Brown, but he got walloped as soon as he let that one go.
Yeah, Tyreek Johnson was in there in a hurry. Big third down here for Jack State.
Big third and 11. 7:34 left in the quarter. Webb to Lewis. Lewis makes one man miss. Picks up a couple. Tyreek Johnson with the stop.
Are you surprised at where we are with this game right now and the punches back and forth?
Absolutely.
I mean, the crowd has kind of gone silent.
But, you know, listen, Jack State didn't get to 7-2 by fluke. Dawson, low kick. They're down at the 26. The Kerryon Joyner checked into the backfield. They roll it out, swing it to Marion Brown. He's brought down at the 29-yard line. Rattler, so far 13-15 here in the first half.
He's made smart decisions, gotten rid of the ball when he has had to, has not taken a sack, hasn't really been hit.
Yeah. again to Leggett. Leggett is knocked out of bounds at about the 39.
Yeah, that one I don't understand. If you're Jack Shea, why are you laying 8 yards off of him? That's an easy free access throw. You got to play him closer than that. Roll to his side.
6 minutes until the half.
As they do now.
Here's Joyner. He's across the 40. Joyner's a guy who started his career as a quarterback, transitioned to wide receiver, and now playing running back.
You see Leggett going to the opposite side. Again, you can't play 8 yards off of him. They'll just raise up and throw the ball to him.
Joyner, left side. Third down coming.
How about the quickness and the speed of this defense? They keep putting South Carolina in these third and long situations.
And keep in mind, 0-for-4 on third down is South Carolina thus far.
Third down.
0-for-4. Looking at a third and 7 from their own 42. They will get the football to begin the second half. Ooh, did Jacksonville State jump off? They say no. Rattler throwing, and there's their first. Third down conversion. Xavier Leggett.
No panic by Rattler. Wasn't sure how many guys would be blitzing, but there you see Leggett. He recognizes that he's got to shorten his route. Wide open, finds that middle space, and Rattler finds him in a hurry. Well done.
Rattler again through the air. And for the first time, well, Joshua Simon comes off his hands down to the field, and Lauren.
Yeah, guys, offensive coordinator Dow Loggins said Spencer's ability to process information and go through his progressions is really impressive. His willingness to stand tall in the pocket under pressure, protecting the football, it's huge. And if you have a great quarterback and can minimize those turnovers, you'd expect a little bit of a better record from this football team. But Coach said he's a great teammate and really continues to step up and show that leadership.
Anderson, boy, he ran into a brick wall named Devin Baldwin.
6'4", 270. Baldwin has been in the backfield multiple times today. And just watch how he drives back the center, Nick Gargiulo. Wow. Another injury, South Carolina offensive line. Man, they have been put through the ringer this season.
That's Cason Henry. So 1-for-5 is South Carolina on third down.
That shows you all the injuries they've had this season. Look at that right tackle. They've had 4 different right tackles this season.
Joyner, Anderson in the backfield. Third and 12 from their own 45, and we got a flag.
Another false start.
False start. Offense, number 53. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Make it about third and 17 coming.
You just feel the confidence growing for Jack State and the unease in this stadium with these fans.
Offensive penalty for South Carolina. So third and 17, 3:42 left here in the first half. Rattler rolling right, flush, throws. Out of bounds. That was Kamari Stevens who applied the pressure.
Yeah, just looking across the field at Jack State and their sideline, and the confidence that you see, the guys slapping hands. I mean, remember, a lot of these players never thought they'd have the possibility of playing at the FBS level or playing in a stadium like this. And they certainly are acting like they belong.
Kroger punting it away. Joyner calling for the fair catch at his own 8. 3:18 until the half. We're all tied up at 14 here in Columbia. Active streak among FBS schools. And they've now run for 100 as Malik Jackson pushes the
Well, Rich
the
Rodriguez
pile forward.
Knows the run game. He is the father of the zone read. He created that, and that changed offensive football and college football 15, 20 years ago.
He's done it with these dual threat quarterbacks. Zion Webb has it, keeps it.
Rich Rod brought option football back into vogue. And man, you talk about quarterbacks. He's had some guys.
It's Webb again. The push. This should be enough to give them a first down.
Zion Webb. Yeah, I think you're right. Yep. Should be. Webb is the latest of really talented quarterbacks Rich Rod has had. I think it all began with Sean King.
Webb keeping it.
Yep.
That's another first down. He ran it 20 times last week for over 100 yards.
Rich Rod coached Sean King at Tulane.
I think he's a little hurt, though.
Yeah. Banged up a bit. Sean King was a great college quarterback. Had a really good NFL career. And
man, maybe a shoulder. So Smothers comes in now. It's his show. First and 10. High snap. Smothers got it. Got back to the line of scrimmage, and that was it. Take a look at what Smothers has done so far this season. Smothers gets to the outside. That's a first down.
The misdirection, the counter. Again, we talked about that play being big for Jack State. You take a look at Webb. Good to see him up. But that counter is effective against all the aggressive play.
Smothers throwing, looking for Carter, and a flag. Keenan Nelson Jr. is back there in coverage.
Pass interference, defense, number 18. 15-yard penalty.
Which Carter tries to go up and get this and can't go over the defender, Nelson, to make the play. And Nelson has no idea where the ball is. He's trying to double him from the inside. Got to find the ball.
Smothers taking the hit. Keenan Nelson Jr. get called on that penalty. Keep in mind, DQ Smith is their starting safety, but he's out this first half because of targeting from last week. Smothers under pressure throwing and to the sideline. And it's out of bounds.
Rich
Looking
Rod,
at P.J. Wells.
Rich Rod has confidence, clearly, in Smothers. He's brought him in, firing off the bench, rolling him left and right, drop back. He's opened up the playbook with him.
Jack State looking to get on the board before the half. He's in South Carolina, and they were going to bring the pressure here. Did they fumble the football?
Did he lose that?
Looked like Smothers lost it. And he did. Tonka Hemingway comes up with it.
Couldn't tell if the snap was low or bat. No, he's got it. He just off his leg. Yeah, that was just all on Smothers. Never looked like he had complete control of the ball.
They needed takeaways. It was something that South Carolina's defense has not had the past 3 weeks. They get a big one and an opportunity to put some points on the board before the half and get the football to begin the second half.
And Jack State should be looking for 17. Where is Leggett? And how do you double him?
He's in the slot. Rattler. Throwing. Leggett. The catch. Breaks the tackle. Down the sideline. Leggett. Inside the 10. Touchdown. South Carolina. Say he stepped out of bounds at the five.
He's the one guy Jack State could not afford to ignore or lose. He had to be the guy that they were going to double, yet they didn't double him. He was in the slot and ran completely free from the right side of the formation to the left side.
So instead of a 49-yard touchdown, it'll go as a 44-yard pickup.
Plenty of time. South Carolina down here.
First and goal. Rattler to the end zone. Incomplete.
Let's go back to Leggett's run.
There's that foot.
Kind of odd. It's the right foot.
Right. You think it'd be the left. Yeah,
exactly.
Second and goal. Rattler looking to Leggett, too high. Fred Perry right with him.
You want to force the throw to the back of the end zone defensively. You don't want to give short, easy throws. You want to force the quarterback to throw to the back of the end zone. Great job by Perry. And now a big third down. I expect pressure.
Third and goal. Rattler looking, throwing, end zone, wide open. Touchdown, Xavier Leggett.
How do you not find him? How do you lose 17 down there? He's the first option, the second option, and the third option down there. Wow. And Spencer Rattler waited for him and waited.
Mitch Jeter with the extra point. And South Carolina go 4 plays and 49 yards, and they did it in just 30 seconds. And Xavier Leggett with the touchdown catch put the Gamecocks up 7. Just 23 seconds left until the half.
Yeah, let's go back to this touchdown play. There is a tight end. Watch him just run a little out route. But listen, who's your threat? They're playing a little zone and passing off, and no one pays attention to Leggett. And you know, when you're playing zone coverage like that, you have to know where the other threat is coming from, particularly number 17. You cannot pass him off. Everybody, he's doing both.
Zion Webb is back in for Jack State. Ron Wiggins gets tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. Keenan Nelson with the stop. It's a 3-yard loss.
If you're Jack State, you got to be content if you can get the halftime down 7.
Their second charge timeout of the half. It's 30 seconds in length.
Rod Smith, I remember him saying two things. We got to protect the football. We can't beat ourselves. Wiggins, the carry.
South Carolina.
South Carolina will use that last timeout.
It's 30 seconds and left.
South Carolina wants.
So third and 10 here for Jack State. And they're going to take a knee. And heading to the locker room down seven. And feel pretty good that you're down seven.
Yeah, absolutely. Jack State's got to feel like they are completely in this ball game. They made a couple mistakes. Look, the best thing for South Carolina is that they know that when they protect Playham, don't let him dominate the second half the way he dominated the first half. And if you're South Carolina, keep going to him until they prove that they can stop him.
Xavier Leggett, 144 yards receiving in that first half. You know, only three South Carolina players have done that in the past 20 seasons. Juice Wells, Sidney Rice, and Alshon Jeffrey. We talked about that turnover, the only one. That's been the difference here, partner, in this game.
Yeah, right at midfield, and then that led to this catch and run by Leggett that set it his own five-yard touchdown catch right before the half. Stepped out there. And we just have not seen Jack State really adjust to make sure they have someone on him at all times or doubling him.
First and 10, South Carolina. Play fake to Anderson. Rattler over the middle, throwing Nick Harbor, the freshman, and it's picked off. Kakura Tarnu. And that is what Jacksonville State has done this season. Takeaways, third in the country. They've got 10 different players with at least one interception. That's the most of any FBS team.
Yeah, Spencer Rattler waited too long and didn't put this out far enough. And a really good job by Tarnu coming back underneath to make the play. He was locked up man-to-man on Harbor. And, you know, Nick Harbor can fly. I mean, he's like a 20-second flat 200-meter guy, you know, looking at the Olympics next season.
19th takeaway by the defense of Jacksonville State. So first and 10 now for the Gamecocks of Jacksonville State. Webb keeping it. Webb's got a lot of room. He's got a block. And he's across midfield. Eamon Worry makes the stop. And is that Webb still down, getting up slowly? A 26-yard
gain. I think you're right. Like every time he hits the turf, like he re-injures that shoulder.
Logan Smothers will come back in. And you see Webb going right to the tent.
Yep.
And Smothers comes in the ball game. Wiggins in the backfield. And it's Wiggins who gets the carry. Wiggins breaks the tackle. And Wiggins brought down at the 35. TJ Sanders makes the stop. 11-yard pickup.
Traylon Brown up front. Cameron Griffin, good blocking the right side. Really walling off South Carolina inside.
Wiggins again.
This is that inside zone running play. Not really the bread and butter for Jack State. They're more of a perimeter team, but they're running inside well.
Now they'll pitch it to Wiggins. Cuts back. He's got a first down.
Yeah. This is right now, this is like a pitcher on the hill, throwing a fastball, then going to the changeup, mixing it up against his defense, and it's working. A little bit inside run, a little bit outside. There'll be a counter in here soon for play action. And they can attack the safeties. The slot guy against the safety is a good matchup for Jack State.
Smothers, design run, hole for him. He's brought down at the 15. DQ Smith seeing his first action. He had a targeting call at the second half of last week's game, so he had to sit out the first half of this game. Again, it's Smothers. Inside the 15, in the red zone. Kilgore makes the stop.
Quarterback run game in the red zone. Advantage Jack State. Now you have an extra blocker because your quarterback is your ball carrier.
There's DQ seeing his first action here. First and 10 from the 15. Smothers to the edge. Fumbles the football out of bounds. Eamon Worry with the stop.
If you're thinking matchups, again, that slot matchup on the far side of the field is one place that Jack State has an advantage.
Jack State will go with two tight ends. Brown had a touchdown catch in the first half. Smothers looking for him. He's got it. Brown inside the five. Did he get in? Yes. Touchdown, Jacksonville State.
Did you see that catch? The one-handed grab by Brown? Wow.
Had an impressive one in the first half. How about this one?
Just
one-handed.
A little drag route, and he doesn't need both hands. Just stabs it with the left hand. We talked about him being the glue to this offense and how important he is and his ability to block and obviously to catch.
Karajic with the extra point, and we are tied again here in Columbia. Eight plays, 73 yards, 3 minutes, 2 seconds. Sean Brown with his second touchdown of the afternoon in this game. Both teams have scored after a turnover. Both teams 3-for-3 in the red zone. Again, did he call for fair catch?
Number 5 for the receiving team signaled for a fair catch. Once it's recovered by rule, it is dead. First down, South Carolina at the 15-yard line.
There you go. Let's go down to the field. Here's Lauren Sisler.
Hey, guys, talking to Coach Beamer coming out of the locker room, you know, there was a lot of chatter down here about these guys doing their job, and that was something he emphasized in the locker room. He said, look, he feels like guys are just standing around waiting for someone else to do their job. They really got to pick it up. He did give credit to Jacksonville State for their defense, for the attacking defense, stopping the run. They've only got 9 yards running, of course, after the first half. And he said, look, we've got to eliminate some of these errors, these miscues, and attack in the run game, attack on defense.
Well, that's how you attack that running game. Mario Anderson with the carry.
You know, look.
Four. Chris Hardy with the stop. Spencer Rattler still needs 23 more yards to get to 10,000 in his career. And that's the Leggett.
Still no adjustment by Jack State. Too much room there. You know, back to Lauren's point about, you know, guys standing around. You worry about your team being engaged. When you lose four in a row and you get to November, how engaged is everybody? You see all the room there for Leggett there. And that's an issue.
All dialed in. Pickup. That one to the outside. Looking in reverse field is Leggett.
You know, partner, it's been a long season for these guys. When you think about spring practice, summer ball, and then fall camp. And then when you have a four-game losing streak and now you're in November, it's a long season. And they need something positive and some energy to get them fully engaged. Otherwise, Jack State is going to be in great position to steal this one. But not so much.
They're looking at second and 18. Rattler going through his progressions. And that's complete on Mega Blake.
You said it. Progression. Had plenty of time. Started to his left, came back to his right. Well protected, and another well thrown ball. There are some scouts out there are falling in love with Spencer Rattler.
That's one of his strengths when it comes to going through those progressions. He will sit in there and do it. Under pressure here. And sacked.
I believe that is the first sack of the game.
Wade Drake. You want to talk about calling all the dogs.
Drake. Yeah. He just, done. Oh, he just took the center, pushed him back, got a little help from one of his teammates, Curly Young, 41, also collapsing the pocket.
Fair catch called for. Jacksonville State will start things at their own 35. We're tied up at 21 here in Columbia. University's history here. As this one gets to Ron Wiggins, spinning. Lost a couple.
Steve Spurrier told us that they had 50 former players at the celebration last night. And he was hanging out today with two of his 14 grandchildren.
Wow. Wiggins again. Back to the line of scrimmage, and Debo.
Debo Williams everywhere.
Smothers throwing. Man, to P.J. Wells, and he was just blanketed by Marcellus Dial.
Yeah, you can't cover that any better. I mean, Dial had P.J. wrapped up right off the line of scrimmage. Just look at this end of the play. He is all over him and had a chance to come up with that ball. That's just tremendous man coverage.
So a three and out, Jacksonville State. Oh, off the flat, he's gonna keep it. And he's dropped Shaq Dawson. He had some pressure when he was looking to put that thing out, kept it.
Well, he still could have kicked it. He thought that he could make it, you know, and he didn't realize how far he had to go. Hey, he didn't want this thing to be blocked, but so, okay, smart decision here. And he's like, oh, he said, wait, I can run. Oh, no, wait, I got a lot further to go. This goes as a turnover, really. He still had time to kick that ball away, to punt it away. Right here, he can punt it away.
Yeah. Good recognition by Brian Thomas Jr., though, to come back and make the stop. Rattler throwing. And in and out of the hands of Tyshawn Russell.
Mark that play. That could be a huge play in this game. Great field position for South Carolina. Momentum shifting from Jack State back to South Carolina. You know, partner, when you play defense, when you come out on the field for these, this is put out the fire time.
Yeah.
You don't worry about the mistakes. Our duty is to put out the fire.
Here's Anderson. And he is dropped. Kamari Stevens was the first to meet him.
And that is the point, putting out the fire. Offense makes a mistake. Sudden change. Your unit goes on the field. You have to be mentally alert, aggressive, and it's your job to put out the fire. And look at what happens with Stevens. Kamari Stevens drives into the backfield.
5 yard loss. Anderson, Joyner in the backfield. Rattler looking. He'll keep it. Brought down by Curly Young Jr.
Go, no go. This would be about a
fourth and six.
52-yard field goal from here.
Coach Beamer said, at the 35, I'm kicking the field goal.
Yeah, he's leaning towards going for it here.
So fourth and six. Jacksonville State 37. Leggett at the top of your screen. Rattler looking his way. He's throwing it to Leggett. Leggett, incomplete. Jamari Jemison, right with him.
Jemison did his best to hold up and stay with him and put pressure on Leggett. This ball's a bit underthrown. If this ball's a little deeper, it's probably six. Bit underthrown. Yeah, if that ball is a little deeper out there, Leggett gets it. But give credit to Jemison for putting a lot of pressure on Leggett, driving, running so hard close to him so that nothing was easy. He couldn't come back and grab it.
And you saw Rattler. Zion Webb is back in for Jacksonville State. Flag. Lewis.
Might be offside.
I think you might be right on that part. That may be on the defense.
Offside. Defense, number 46. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Listen, if I'm Jack State, I'm feeling pretty good because they've run the ball really well. 184 yards rushing already. And in the second half, there's been no evidence that South Carolina can stop them from running the ball.
Yeah, South Carolina's run defense, too, is 11th in the conference. They've given up an average of 140 yards a game. That's Lewis again.
Rich Rod knows how to mix up his run game. He gives you that inside zone. Comes back with a perimeter toss or so. Webb is back in at quarterback. And he will run that counter where he will pull a couple of linemen. But misdirection.
They'll pitch it out. Lewis. Big hit. Spins off of it. That was Debo.
You could tell just by the sound.
Yeah. I mean, Debo is trying to take people's chains, bikes, everything out here today.
His hits have a definite sound to them.
Third and two. 5 of 11 on third down is Jack State. Webb throwing down the seam, looking for Carter. He's got it. Carter, touchdown.
We've been talking about this matchup all game long, the matchup between the slot receiver and the safety. They get DQ Smith matched up on Perry Carter, and that's a mismatch. And the confidence to call that in that situation, and how about Webb giving Carter a chance, not overthrowing him, putting it out there, giving him a chance to make a play.
Extra point is good. Jacksonville State leads for the first time in this game. As Zion Webb goes to their big play guy, Perry Carter, 54 yards to the crib. And it is Jack State on top of South. 8 games, that's the longest streak in the FBS and the longest streak in Gamecock history.
Let's go back to this touchdown pass. Now, here's the matchup on the bottom. Perry Carter against Kilgore, and you see DQ Smith, the free safety number one. Now, when you're in press coverage like that, you have to reroute the receiver. But Kilgore does not get hands on Carter at all. He runs right by him, and the safety was playing too close to the line of scrimmage. He could not have enough depth to help. He was a non-factor because Carter was able to run by both of them.
And what did Rod Smith, offensive coordinator, Jacksonville State, tell us? We got to get Perry Carter the football in the slot. Joshua Simon spinning with the catch. Picks up a couple of more yards. Brought down at the 30. Meanwhile, Rich Rod's squad, you know, they've got 144 yards on 6 third-down conversion plays.
Wow.
Rattler has now surpassed 10,000 yards passing in his career as McDowell runs for a first down.
starting to get a little antsy in these parts.
Here's McDowell again. To the 45, Kywan McCray with the stop.
If ever there was a sense of urgency for this South Carolina team, now's the time. A team that is fighting to get to bowl eligibility finds itself behind in this game against Jack State.
You got to win out. Next four games, including this one, all here at Williams-Brice Stadium. Third and one coming for the Gamecocks of South Carolina. Anderson in the backfield. South Carolina 2 of 9 on third down. Go with the Wildcat here. Is Joyner.
I don't
think he got it.
Not at all.
How about Colby Fuqua?
Well, how about the fans now? You know, we felt and sensed the anxiety in the crowd most of the day. And that run where they didn't pick up the first down, the crowd started responding and booing. Great effort inside by Jeff Marks. The nose tackle slicing in to shut that play down.
Fourth down coming, and it looks like South Carolina go for it. And they're going to talk about it.
Yeah.
South Carolina has called their first charge timeout of the half. It's 30 seconds in length.
Beamer told us yesterday he wanted to keep the crowd into the game, supporting his team. Right now, that crowd is close to turning.
They would be looking at a fourth and a long one. ESPN Analytics give it the green light in this situation. They say go for it.
Yeah, here's your risk, though. You don't make this, you give Jack State a short field, and you're already down a score. That's the risk. Now, I don't think he has a choice. I think he has to go for it. If he punts this ball right here, this crowd might revolt. Yeah.
Well, bring in the punter.
He brings in the punter. The crowd won't like it.
Watch the fake. Yep. Done it before.
Crowd will not like this.
From their own 46, Kai Kroger. And he does punt it this time. Joyner. Let's it go to the end zone. Look at Coach Beamer.
Wow. What would this mean? What would this mean for South Carolina if they don't pull this one out?
Really disappointing.
Yeah.
Really disappointing.
And I'd be worried about the remainder of the season because your last real goal, making a bowl, would be out the window.
Right. And that's where you go when you talk about making sure players stay engaged.
Stay engaged, stay involved, stick with it.
But look, we got a lot of time.
Yep.
2:50 here in the third. Got another quarter as well. Here's Webb. Hands that one off to Wiggins over that left side.
Remember back in the first quarter, we talked about Rich Rod tempo and running a lot, running wide to tire out this defensive front. That might be something to that.
Webb throwing and broken up. Marcellus Dial.
He's played great.
Mm-hmm.
He's played great coverage all afternoon.
He leads the team in pass breakups. Crucial third down now here for Jack State. Third and 6. They go 5 wide. Empty set. Webb under pressure. Escapes. But not that time. Alex Huntley. Boogie went and got him.
local guy. Take a look at the pressure.
It's Debo.
And he manages to escape Debo. But Hundley there to save the day for South Carolina.
Force that three and out. Dawson punting things away. Kilgore from his own 30. Breaks a tackle. Brought down at the 35.
There's some hitting going on out there.
It is. Our Monday Night Football crew heading out to MetLife Stadium for the Chargers, the Jets. It's 8 Eastern, ABC, ESPN, ESPN Deportes. You got Peyton and Eli. Watch both of them on ESPN2. We'll talk about the most passing yards in their first four seasons. Peyton right there at the top. The great Dan Marino and then Justin Herbert. Minute 40 left in the quarter. Rattler looking, going downfield. Leggett, got it. Leggett, loose. Leggett, touchdown. Once again, South Carolina, just like that.
Same route from the slot, deep crossover. And for whatever reason, there's been no adjustment from the first half for Jack State. They haven't bracketed. They haven't held up. Leggett, he's run free through the secondary on that deep over.
The extra point is good. We're tied up again. Xavier Leggett.
Oh, man.
Has a leg up on this defense. He's got 217 yards receiving.
Yeah.
This one from 65
gets
yards
off
out.
The line of scrimmage without being touched. You see the late double coming over by Perry, who has a bad angle underneath him, and he runs through it. So poor execution. You see Perry going to find him, and he can't find him right away. And so Leggett just gets outside, wide open, perfectly thrown ball.
Man, I don't need security around here. This is home for me.
Yeah, they love Debo. Petway and Joyner back deep for Jack State. American when he was here.
Let's go back to the touchdown. And again, right off the bat, this is a safety Perry, and his responsibility is really to find Leggett and double him later. So he comes up. Now he's trying to find Leggett, and he takes the wrong angle inside. Leggett goes outside of him, and that keeps him wide open for a perfectly thrown ball. But Jack State again trying to find a way to contain Leggett.
Rattler is now thrown for 328 yards. Zion Webb going back to work. And that's thrown out of bounds.
Miscommunication.
And for Spencer Rattler, he's now thrown for more than 300 yards four times now this season.
Wow.
Seventh career 300-yard passing game for Spencer Rattler.
See what he can do when he's not flat on his back.
Intentional grounding, offense, number 10.
They're going to call that one on Zion Webb.
Intentional grounding, offense, number 10. The penalty is loss and down the spot of the foul, second down.
Route.
Oh, the jet sweep blown up.
Wow. Van Martin Scott.
Oh, giant. Webb looking down the sideline. Back shoulder throw and a flag. O'Donnell Fortune was in coverage.
Pass interference, defense, number 3. The penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot, includes an automatic first down.
Easy call. Usually pass interference is the most difficult call to make, but you get your arms up on the guy and you can't find the ball. That's an easy call for the official.
He was trying to get it out to Quentin Lane. 6 penalties on both teams. Maybe a yard. Under a minute left in the quarter.
I'm not sure how many people saw this coming. 28-28, late third quarter. Wow.
Webb throwing again to Lane. Incomplete. Fortune right with him again.
Rich Rod told us earlier this week, find a way to get to the fourth quarter and be in it. That's the goal.
Third and 9. Webb steps, throw, high, incomplete. Lane again, the intended target.
He had him. A little cover 2 concept over there, the corner short and the safety deep. And he tried to get Lane in between them. Just too much, too high. See, he's got enough protection, a good job by the back coming over, but just too much heat on that ball.
Dawson punting it away. Kilgore drives him back to the 18. Punt. Tuesday, I have the exclusive reveal of the next college football playoff top 25 rankings. Reese and the guys are going to break them all down top to bottom at 7 Eastern, ESPN and the app. Last time we saw Spencer Rattler, took him 1 play, 11 seconds to strike.
One thing Jacks State has to do is find 17.
Low snap. Rattler throwing on the run. Gets loose again. And can't come up with that one. There's a flag, though. He was with Jeremiah Harris.
It's almost comical how wide open he's getting.
Pass interference, defense number 14. The penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot and includes an automatic first down.
I mean, Leggett right off the bat. Look, just a quick snap inside. Wide open. It's unbelievable. I mean, there are packages you can use to try and slow him down. There are ways to double him. There are ways to have a guy in his face and get hands on him and to disrupt his route, but none of that's being tried right now.
On the ground, Anderson. We have played 3 quarters.
That's the end of
here
the third
in South
quarter.
Carolina. It's the battle of the Gamecocks, and we're all tied up at 28. The 4-353. He threw for 438 when he was at Oklahoma once. Rattler looking left. Got a man open. That's the tight end, Simon.
Let's not forget what's at stake. South Carolina trying to make a bowl game.
They
have to win their final 4, including today.
They got that snap off quickly. Anderson breaking tackles across midfield. Keeps the legs turning.
Sense of urgency right now for South Carolina.
Got to win out if they want to be bowl eligible.
And for Jack State, they would love to have a program-defining win under Rich Rod.
First season in FBS, and here's a sack. J-Rock.
Let's not forget, Jack State, a couple years ago, knocked off Florida State in that stadium.
They have, when they were in the FCS, they got that nickname, the Giant Killers. They beat Ole Miss in double overtime in 2010, 49-48. As you pointed out, Florida State in 2021. And remember, they took what Auburn, which was ranked sixth at the time, into overtime back in 2015. Before they lost by just 7 points. Marion Brown.
And Rich Rod wants to have one of those kind of wins under his belt as the new head coach at Rich at Jack State. Second year for him.
Rattler under pressure and sacked. Chris Hardy, the best defensive lineman on this squad.
Yeah, they ran a little stunt and got him free. He's one of the hardest guys to play. He was a high school running back, and you can see those skills. See him as he makes his move, come on, around a little stunt, unblocked. Good call, perfect timing.
Loss of 11. Second and 21. Rattler, check down. Anderson. Got most of the lost yardage back. Third down coming for South Carolina.
I think if you're South Carolina, you're thinking four down territory. You want to get half of this and give yourself a chance to have a fourth down shot at it.
Leggett has been the guy. Rattler. That's batted. Back to Rattler. Hardy again. That'll bring up fourth down. If you're the quarterback, can't run with that.
He is second all time in tackles for loss for this team, and you see him with that left paw get up there and knock that one down. Big plays.
Look, Rattler tried to sell that like, oh, no, I caught that near. Sees Jacksonville State calling a timeout.
Jacksonville State has called their first charge timeout of the half.
Looks like I think they only had like 10 guys on the field.
Jacks to play.
And we talked tackles for loss, sixth in the country coming into this game. Fair catch called for at the 12. 11:49 left. We're all tied up here in South Carolina. And keeps it. Webb over the right side. And brought down at the 18-yard line. 6-yard pickup.
Jacksonville State can remain in the game as the helmet came off as a result of the foul.
Let's see. No wonder that helmet came off.
The whistle probably already had blown. No reason for the extracurricular.
Oh, right there. Yeah, there it is.
Yep. Aaron Willis.
Ole Miss transfer. Wiggins again getting the carry.
Almost 200 yards rushing for Jack State.
They're at 199.
Wow. Did not see that happening. Not against a bigger front, an SEC front.
Wiggins again spins, He's about a yard shy of another first down, so it'll be third and one.
And Rich Rod is a master play caller. He knows how to mix these things up. Here we go, hurry up.
The push. The tush push.
Might not have been enough.
First down, Jack State.
Oh, he gave it to him. And this is Rich Rod's element right now. Close game. He can mix up his play calling.
He hands that one off to Wiggins. Cross midfield flag again. They're going to call that again on South Carolina's defense.
Legal substitution.
Illegal substitution, defense, 12 players on the field to snap. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot, repeat first down.
These penalties have really helped the Jacksonville State drive. They were backed up, and now look where they are, midfield.
From their own 49, two tight ends. Wiggins cross midfield. That's a first inning fumble. Ripped from him. Oh, my. You want to talk about a momentum swing.
He had picked up the first down.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
Second turnover of the day for Jacksonville State.
Fighting for a little extra.
By the defense. First down, South Carolina. Please reset the game clock to 9:49.
Tyus Greer, the transfer from Syracuse.
Yeah, Tyus Greer, number 12, comes in here and is ripping that ball out.
Mm-hmm.
Greer is 6'6", 245. And was able to rip that ball away from the much smaller Wiggins. Big, big, big turnover.
From their own 45, Rattler looking, throwing. Anderson got a block. Anderson out of bounds.
And Rattler still well protected, actually has choices. He had his choice of Leggett down the field again. They still haven't figured out a way to cover him.
18-yard pickup. From the Jacksonville State 37. Anderson picks up a couple.
How aggressive will Jack State be now in defense? They've had trouble defending on the back end. Will they dial up a little bit more pressure to try to get to Rattler?
Left in the corner. Rattler looking, going downfield. Leggett got it. Leggett loose. Leggett touchdown once again. South Carolina just like that. That tied up this football game, and that's where we stand right now. 28 all, 9 minutes left in this game. South Carolina needs to win out to become bowl eligible. Jacksonville State, first season in the FBS, and boy, they're looking for a signature victory. Second down, Rattler throwing. And that's Simon. And he is down at the 20.
The entire playbook is open now for South Carolina. They haven't had much success running today, but here inside almost the red zone, they've got options.
17-yard pickup, Juju McDowell. Makes a man miss. Brought down at the 15, Quay Drake with the stop. in the red zone now for South Carolina.
And this is where you would expect Jack State to dial up the pressure. And if they do that, there's a really good chance that on the back end, Leggett will be in single coverage.
Both of these teams have been perfect in the red zone. South Carolina 3-for-3. Inside handoff. Cutback, McDowell. At the 11 is the stop.
Juju McDowell, great stutter step, stop and go. Getting positive yardage. A little life to the rushing attack because of him.
Little tempo here. Rattler keeping it. Third and one. That's a first down. South Carolina was 3-for-12 in this game on third down. They were 1-for-5 in this half. Now 2-for-6. Anderson checks back in the backfield. Seven minutes. Anderson gets the call. Anderson puts his head down. Upended at the 3.
This offensive line has been much maligned this season because of all the sacks allowed and the like, but they have played great tonight. And down here, clutch, where they needed to run the ball, this offensive line has been blowing open some holes.
Second and goal. Leggett at the bottom of your screen. Harbor at the top. Rattler looking under pressure. Sacked. Hardy again. There's a reason why he's a two-time Conference USA Defensive Player of the Week.
Yeah, and some credit on the back end. He wanted to go to Leggett, but good coverage forced him to hang on to the ball for a minute. Just enough time for Hardy to get in and make the play, but good coverage on Leggett on
third
the back end.
And goal. Leggett at the bottom.
He should draw a lot of attention.
Rattler looking his way. Double covered though. And a strike to Simon. Incomplete though. Dropped.
Really nice job by Jack State on the back end. They doubled Leggett. Had a guy inside and a guy outside. And that forced Spencer to go to his alternate receiver. Mm. And there was decent coverage there. And just Simon couldn't come up with it. That looked catchable.
It was. It was on the money. Mitch Jeter coming in. 10th play of this drive. This is from 25 yards out. 10 of 12 on the season. For the lead. Good. Three-point lead for South Carolina. South Carolina has scored 10 points off of 2 turnovers. Jacksonville State, 7 points off of 1 turnover. It's been the difference. And one of the difference for Jacksonville State, Zion Webb. Got it done early with his arm, Deshaun Brown, one of his 2 touchdowns, and then he got it done with his legs. Injured his shoulder on that run, came back into the game, had another big run, injured his shoulder again, but came back again. The kid's a gamer. How about 4 yards up top to Perry Carter down the seam? And now Webb looking to lead the Gamecocks to a victory.
54 yards rushing on the evening.
Jet sweep to Carter. Maybe a yard. Debo, another stop.
If I'm Jack State, the guy that I want to make sure is involved is Sean Brown, the tight end. If I need a block, I want to run it to his side. If I need a catch, I want him involved.
Webb looking at Carter, makes the catch. About a yard shot, the first down. Clock running.
So much at stake for both these teams.
Webb keeping it. He's got a first down. And the helmet comes off. It's third time, Zion Webb.
He may have to step out this time.
You're right.
I mean, nobody ripped off his helmet this time. This is not buckled well enough.
Smothers has come in. So has Anwar Lewis. Lewis gets the call. Across the 40.
Nothing,
under 5 minutes.
Nothing fancy, just that little inside zone right behind that little double team on the nose, trying to get a few yards.
See, they tightened up that some straps on there, and here comes Zion Webb. Second and 7.
This is why Webb came back for his 7th year. Chance to play in a big time environment like this.
Throwing, looking for Carter. Incomplete. Double covered.
Really good coverage on the back end by South Carolina. That would have taken a perfect throw. And Carter, normally you're trying to match him on that seam route or that post route. They switched it up that time.
Jacksonville State in this game, 8 of 16 on third down, but just 1 of 6 on third and long. Looking at third and 7. Webb throwing. Carter caught. I mean, he's right there at the marker.
I think he's going to have a first down.
Yes,
I think
he will.
Back. Yeah.
They're going to move the chains at their own 49. It's an 8-yard pickup.
Really good hands by Carter. He played for Rich Rod at Louisiana Monroe and followed him over to Jack State.
Leads the team in receiving yards. Webb keeps it. Good fake. And he's brought down at the 45 of South Carolina. Debo with another tackle.
They're chewing up the clock and running the offense they want. Jet sweep, fake jet sweep, inside zone.
Webb, another keep. Third down coming again.
Substitute on the field for Jack State. Opportunity for South Carolina to match if they want. They choose not to.
9 of 17 on third down. Carter, top of your screen in the slot. They're going to go to the outside, though. He was looking at P.J. Wells.
Did he make that catch?
Oh, P.J.!
Did he make that catch?
Man!
Oh, my goodness. We have seen some grabs here today.
20-yard pickup. Flag.
Holding. Defense number 6. The penalty is declined. Results of the play is a first down.
Marcellus Dial in coverage. It didn't matter.
P.J. Wells, all 6'3" of him, being held, gets the one hand up and comes up with a big catch late fourth quarter here. Are you kidding me? He's only got one hand he can use, and he comes up with it.
This guy was a starter for them last season. Man, he's come up big here with 2:30 left in this game.
And now if you're Rich Rod, you want to manage the clock, too.
Anwar Lewis, nothing. That's Tonka.
Now,
if you're Sean, has called their second charge timeout of the half.
I was just about to say, if you're Sean Beamer, you got to think about using your timeout, saving some clock.
1-6.
That was the 10th play of that drive.
Thank you.
Webb throwing. Picked off! And it's a pick 6 to the crib. Stone Blanton with a stone cold pick 6. And that just might do it.
play of the game. Stone Glenton locked up with the receiver out of the backfield, Lewis, and the ball was late, didn't have a lot on it, and Glenton played it perfectly. Glenton is coming out to try to make sure he gets the running back, has to take a wide, wide range there. That ball is late, and boy, is he on time. With a convoy to the end zone, and South Carolina is going to remain in the hunt for a bowl game.
87-yard pick six by Stone Blanton. First interception of the season for the sophomore. Oh boy, did it come at the right moment for the Gamecocks.
Yeah, he was locked up, single coverage, and play of the season for South Carolina. Instead, a pick six by Blanton to seal it for the Gamecocks.
Shane Beamer looking to put an end to that four-game losing streak. South Carolina about to go 12-0 against Conference USA opponents since the 2000 season.
And so South Carolina has the superior rights to the mascot and the name in this battle of Gamecocks.
Yeah, they can certainly be cocky today.
Let's see what you did there.
You know, past three games, South Carolina, no takeaways. Different story here today. Three of them. Couple of fumbles. And now pick six. Smothers in at quarterback. Webb went into the tent.
Well, we heard Sean Beamer tell Shimmy earlier in the game they had to get takeaways.
Yeah.
He was frustrated that they hadn't been able to do that for a few weeks.
Yeah, Coach Shane really imploring his defense. And they might have just gotten another one. As Smothers throws it to O'Donnell Fortune.
Well, this might just be the momentum South Carolina needs for this stretch run in November. So you see perfect position over there for the pick by Fortune.
Four takeaways for South Carolina.
And they will be home the rest of the season. They need three more wins after today to become bowl eligible.
That's the play. That's sportsmanlike conduct. Intercepting team. 15-yard penalty, of course. Big first and 10 for South Carolina.
So now push them back a little bit. You talked about that schedule, partner, and this is what they've got. Vanderbilt, Kentucky, and Clemson.
Yeah, you see the win probability lowest for that last game with Clemson.
Clemson whooped up on Notre Dame today,
didn't they,
too.
Though, yeah.
Anderson with the carry. Jacksonville State got another timeout left.
Please reset the game clock to 1 minute 36 seconds. 1:36.
Here's a look.
There's another one. Yeah.
Yeah. This kid's talented too. And there's Simon. He's had a heck of a day as well. Yeah. 20-yard pickup for Simon. No more timeouts for Jacksonville State. So now, South Carolina, you can just sit down on it.
Well, and they can start to look forward to the November run that they want to get to six wins.
With it, the South Carolina Gamecocks say to you, improve to you here tonight.
Oh. The big improvement was the protection. for Spencer Rattler. You give him a chance to be a quarterback, he shows you his NFL talent. And he put it on display today. They protected him. He threw it deep. He moved well. Give him a little protection, and this offense can move.
Spencer Rattler, Xavier Leggett. The big story offensively, the defense coming up with four turnovers after having none the past 3 weeks. The story for South Carolina here in Columbia. Rattler throws for 399. 217 receiving for Leggett. 38.